Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman. Today we're going to walk through creating your very first Windows Azure application using .NET and Visual Studio. It only takes 3 minutes and it's free. There's three ways to put your site in Windows Azure: websites, virtual machines, and cloud services. In this video, we'll see how to deploy an ASP.NET application to a website. Let's make a small Hello World application. I'll start out in the Azure portal. I don't have anything running right now in my Azure account, so I'll click New. I can make a new website, virtual machine, cloud service, and more. I'll click on Website. From here, I can do a quick create, a create with database, or pull in one of many open source applications from the gallery. I'll just do a quick create. We'll call it Hanselman Test. Then I'll click Create Website. You can see that the creation of the website is happening in the background. They're letting me know something's happening, but I'm free to do other administrative tasks if I like. There, my site's now up and running. I can click on it and see the status of my site within the dashboard. You can see here in the graph that nothing's happened so far because my site's currently empty and it just started running. I can click Configure and configure my application for various versions of .NET or PHP. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to download my site's publish profile. This publish profile is going to be imported into Visual Studio. I'll save the publish profile in my downloads folder. Now I'll switch over to Visual Studio. From here, I'll make a new project. I'm going to create an ASP.NET MVC4 application using .NET 4. I'll make a regular internet application and click OK. Now I'll compile and run the application locally and see what it looks like. Here's my standard ASP.NET application running on localhost on my machine. From Visual Studio, I'll right-click on the project in Solution Explorer and click Publish. Now I'm going to import the publish profile that we downloaded earlier. And it fills out everything that we need to deploy my application using WebDeploy. I'll validate the connection, then I'll hit Publish. You can see the deployment happening in the output window. Deployment to Windows Azure takes just a few seconds. After the deployment, my application automatically starts up. You can see now that my application is running in Windows Azure, not on localhost. I'll switch back over to the Azure dashboard where I can see CPU time, requests, data in and out, and any errors that may have occurred. I've just deployed to a shared instance. The best part is that a single instance is free, but if I want, I could use multiple shared instances or switch over to a reserved instance for more control. As a reserved instance, I could have a small, medium, or large instance size, and then scale even more with multiple reserved instances. I'll switch back to Visual Studio and make a small change to my application. I'll then right-click and publish to redeploy this small change. I can see which file will be updated, and then hit Publish. Notice how fast the small redeployment is. Deploying my app took just a few minutes, and I was able to use the Visual Studio and .NET skills I already had. If you know Visual Studio and .NET, you'll be able to easily deploy to Azure as well. Please visit the Developer Center at windowsazure.com to learn more.